There they go, Barbie and Ken. Come on, people, give it up. Do I have to send more caffeine to your tables? It is my special privilege to introduce our next surprise guest. You know, if imitation is the best form of flattery, then this person is being flattered from coast to coast, 24/7. Even here in Las Vegas, a very famous review show is knocking her off, in your lingo terms. That's why we here in Infoland have the original, the new, the improved, the safe, the get your money back guarantee. Funny, the hell with the FTC. Here we have the none and only, the wonderful comedian. She's a wonderful lady. I've known her for years. Please welcome Joan Rivers.
Okay, so, why am I here? I buy all your shit, let me tell you. I get up at night, that fucking bug thing, I have it. I can't tell you. I have the potato thing, I kill my dog with that. I mean, and my daughter has that stupid air bed, which is wonderful and congratulations, but how do you get the fucking air out? But anyhow, so why am I here? You've ordered born again Christians, I am a spend again Jew. And I just, but that's not why I came. I came seriously, and I came, by the way, directly from England to do this tonight, to honor this gentleman. And I was over in England performing, and also I cremated my mother-in-law, which we won't go into. And well, time management. And I was flying home this morning. I thought I should have waited till she was dead, but you know, that. But she was one of those women who's always saying, I want to be buried, I want to be cremated. And I had the time between rehearsal and performance, and let's do it, Betty. It's not always about you, you know. So anyhow, let me get to why I'm here. Because I just want to say, you shouldn't be cremated, because I was thinking about it all the way home. And no, because you don't know where the ashes end up. I was really thinking about it. And if I was cremated, I could end up being snorted by Whitney Houston, and that would scare, oh! Is that an ending to end up in Bobby Brown's ass? I mean, it's just. So, anyhow. Just a little word to all of you infomercialies. The reason I'm here, seriously, 11 years ago, when QVC really, they only had dead celebrities. I mean, they would sit them up and work their mouths. And, Carol Channing trying to sell this terrible, this diamond-like shit. Anyhow, I met with somebody who I thought was so brilliant, and I said, that's the future, and boy, oh boy, was I right about that one. Every industry has someone that has made their mark, that has raised the bar, that has made the industry bigger and better, and this gentleman, I think, my God, he made certainly the all the shopping at home, totally, Joe Segel, who is absolutely a genius. He revolutionized what is going on in television. But not only that, Joe Segel started, Franklin Mint. Look at this group. Well, who cares? I own those goddamn Hollywood Square plates. I mean, it's like, Joe Segel is a visionary. He founded Franklin Mint. He founded QVC. He founded 50 other companies. He is, well, let me just show you. Let's watch here for a second, because I can't even tell you what this man has done, which is so amazing. So let's look at the video.
I wasn't surprised to hear that Joe Segel was being honored by the ERA. As the founder of QVC, Joe has certainly done a lot to help this industry. And of course, his values and principles are legendary. What surprises me about tonight's honor, though, is that Joe is receiving a Lifetime Achievement Award, which makes it sound like he's finished, that he's done with his career. Why are you accepting this award, Joe? Don't you think it's a little premature? Let's face it, you retire all the time, but you always end up starting another business. When you retired from the Franklin Mint, it wasn't long until you bought a hotel and started an airline. When you retired from your software testing business, you started QVC. And since you retired from QVC, I know of at least three new businesses that you have been involved with. Let's face it, Joe, if it wasn't for your ability to retire, you might not have gotten anywhere in life. Joe, you've started over 20 businesses so far, and I bet your career is far from over. So maybe this award they are giving you should be called a Midlife Achievement Award, since even though we never know what you'll do next, we do know it will be good. As a colleague and a friend, I congratulate you, and I know there are a few other people that would like to say a few words as well.
Some years ago, Joe Segel came into my office with a mutual friend and told me that he was trying to make up his mind as to whether he should go into the mail order business or go into television merchandising. And in my questioning of him of what was his background, he told me that he was the man who created the Franklin Mint. I said, Mr. Segel, if you created that business, what I would do if I were you, I would go into the television merchandising.
We looked around at the other people that were in the business or getting into the business at that time, of which there were about 20. And we realized we could do it an awful lot better. And we really set off on that mission to really set ourselves apart.
You know, Joe's vision of the future was really quite simple and, in Joe's mind, very crystal clear. Instead of allowing technology to really shape this new format called electronic retailing, he really directed an entire QVC team towards the simple roots of neighborly retailing. It was know your customer extremely well, listen to understand what she wants and what she needs, and make it the responsibility of every single employee in the company to service the customer.
He just had a complete vision. It wasn't just an idea. It was a complete vision from, this is what we're going to do, but it was also, this is exactly how we're going to do it. And I think that made a huge difference, not only to QVC, but to the industry.
Americans are spending more time watching television than ever before. And people are now spending more time doing their shopping from home by phone than ever before. The two trends together are basically the foundation of our business.
QVC, when they went that first year, they did $112 million in sales. They set a record in American business history.
I've given a lot of thought as to why Joe Segel is successful. To me, it comes down to his ability to get the best out of everyone that worked for him.
Thinking about Joe, I think of the term excellence. And when you worked with Joe, you never did anything partway. You never did it good enough. It was either you did it at an excellent level, in an excellent fashion, or you didn't do it at all.
He had a passion for and a commitment to excellence. He was known for his attention to detail.
I think Joe helped me help us be pioneers in this industry.
He brought the excellence to the industry that has allowed it to become so dominant and so popular today.
To be involved in an industry from the outside, being in the doors of QVC, being part of this amazing industry that is changing people's lives, that has set a standard for what everybody else strives for now. It is a great feeling when people introduce me as Joe Segel's son. I am so proud of that and so proud of what my father built here at QVC.
Joe was a passionate believer in the law of format, and he believed that if you could make a mistake, acknowledge it and fix it on air, it was a wonderful way to build trust. And quite frankly, he was a pioneer in that regard.
And the true aspect of Joe can always do it better, he thought he would be the best guest on air.
Introductory price, and I'm learning how to look at the right camera here. It's what happens when an amateur gets
it's
on.
It's like learning how to shave all over again. Yeah, it can be confusing.
Let's see if there's anything we forgot to mention here.
Now, as program hosts, we all received a lot of coaching from Joe Segel, from Mr. Segel. He would watch and he would get a memo about what words to use, what words not to use. And then Mr. Segel decided to go on the air.
Maxine, my pleasure to be here. Rod, welcome to you. Thank you, thank you.
You're going to do something that I've been waiting to see, because we're going to take our notepads out and we're going to watch and see if he makes any mistakes.
But I know that all our hosts and hostesses are watching.
Oh, boy, are they watching. Well, this man...
Now, I'll get a memo instead of they're getting a memo.
It was not unusual for Joe at all, any time of day, to be calling down to the studio.
When I had finished a cell and tossed it to my co-host, my producer got in my ear and said, come down, there's a phone call. At 4 in the morning. And I come down with Joe and he said, Bob, I think you need to do a little bit more work on your cuticles. He was so attentive to detail. All of us still to this day believe that Joe does not need sleep.
There was a guy that was kicking packages down the stairs. I just thought, who is this crazy man kicking these packages down the stairs? And I later learned it was Joe Segel doing his famous drop test. And if the package, the product was still in one piece when it got to the bottom of the stairs, he thought that then it might make it through the mail system.
Joe's commitment, Joe's long-term vision, and his attention to detail were those three things that really made QVC the success that it is.
Joe set the tone for the entire company. And he wanted to make sure that we had a quality product, quality presentation, and quality customer service.
We have a motto here inside the company: always give the customers more than they expect.
Mr. Segel's mantra was always give the customers more than they expect.
I think the number one business principle that Joe brought to QVC was customer first. Always first, number one. Never think of anything but the customer.
His impact on customer service and the philosophies that he created back in 1986 are still here today, 15 years later.
Dad, I want to congratulate you for winning the Lifetime Achievement Award from the Electronic Retailing Association. Nobody has done more, in my opinion, to change what is now considered standard in the industry, setting a mark for excellence that most people now strive to achieve, which is considered normal and acceptable at QVC. You have done it better than anybody else has. You deserve this award. Enjoy it, and I'm proud to just be in your shadows. Congratulations.
On behalf of everybody at QVC, we thank you. Congratulations on your award.
There was one person missing from that wonderful video, and that is Doris Segel, who is an amazing woman and who has been married to Joe forever. And we should also acknowledge her tonight, because she certainly has been with him through the whole thing. And now, ladies and gentlemen, my pleasure to introduce you to a man who has just given me a big apartment. Mr. Among other things, and a major business, and I'm so proud of. And it's all because of Joe Segel. So, ladies and gentlemen, Joe Segel, man of the year, man of the lifetime, please come up and get your award.
This is really a complete surprise. I'm overwhelmed. It's really Joan.
It really is.
That's terrific. When I was told of this award, I was hesitant because I think that Lifetime Achievement Awards are usually given to people on their last legs. So I hope that you didn't know something that I didn't know. But actually, I know something that you didn't know. And I'll share it with you tonight. When I retired, and I am really retired, and I've been retired even though I had a few little business enterprises that didn't amount to much after I retired from QVC. I'm truly retired. In 1993, which was almost 10 years ago, I entered into an agreement with QVC to serve as chairman emeritus and an exclusive consultant to QVC for 10 years, and that period will be over in 3 months in January of 2003. And I'll share with you the news that tomorrow QVC will announce that we have agreed to extend that agreement for 5 more years, and I will continue as chairman emeritus and an exclusive consultant to QVC for at least till 2008. And I'm proud and happy to do that. I'm of all the businesses I've started, and there were a little bit over, not 50, it was a little over 20, none have made me more proud than QVC. And it's not just because QVC has become such a large and successful enterprise, but more because QVC has continuously does so much to enhance the lifestyles of its employees and its customers. And it just, you know, there's no bad news on QVC. It brings great cheer to everyone. You don't, when you tune to QVC, there's nothing about Iraq or Al-Qaeda or snipers. There's not even any sex or violence on QVC. That is not in front of the cameras. It's really a great company, and I'm proud of the standards and of innovation and excellence that I helped to contribute to QVC. But it's really the people who are there. Not me. I mean, I started it. I introduced a lot of ideas there. But the credit belongs to Doug Briggs and Randy Ronning and the 14,000 other people of QVC who have made it such a successful business in recent years. And now QVC will do about $4 billion worth of business this year. It adds about 40,000 new customers every month, most of whom become repeat customers, and that's really the engine that drives QVC. Customer satisfaction is the key to its success. And it will now, I think this year, it will ship over 100 million packages, which is really amazing. But the unsung heroes of QVC are really its suppliers and the independent concept developers who bring new ideas to QVC. After all, QVC introduces something like over 1,000 new products every month. And if that flow of new products and new ideas did not continue, then the growth could not continue. So I salute all of you. Many of QVC's suppliers and concept developers are here tonight, and I'm particularly proud of my son Marvin, who you saw on that screen, who has, on his own, without my help, developed his own unique company to help suppliers properly position their products and get connected with the right buyers at QVC. And I think that you, as suppliers, really deserve a great deal of credit for QVC's success. I am very appreciative of this award, and I salute all of you. I also want to certainly acknowledge my wife, Doris, my loving wife, who for 39 years has given me great encouragement and support, and that was especially important in the early days. There were some tough times in the first year or two of QVC, and we had some bumps in the road, and she always stood by me. Thank you, Doris. So I salute all of you for your contributions, for making it easier and more comfortable for people to enjoy shopping in the comfort and safety of their home. Thank you very much for this lovely award.
Joe, we're going to
Keep it going for Mr. Joe Segel and his wife Doris. Joan Rivers, huh? Our next celebrity presenter is just a stunningly beautiful woman. As a matter of fact, People Magazine considered her one of the 50 most beautiful people in the world. She was one of the Bold and a Beautiful stars.